हरे कृष्ण, वेलकम टू टुडे सुंदरबा डिस्कशंस। So you can on, everyone can on their videos so that we can see. So today we are going to continue the Ashtesh discussion. So quickly, can anyone revise or recap in Ashtesh class majorly what we discussed? Welcome. Jai Gopinath Prabhu.
So yesterday we started with visheshana yukta, visheshyam is equal to visishtam, and then we defined visheshana is chinmatra, visheshyam is chinmatra satta, and visheshana is jiva. And not only that, it is swamsa chintya shakti, and then how that is defined as the tattvam. Am I making any sense? Am I audible to Hare Krishna?
Audible, Prabhu. Audible. Carry on.
That much only I remember.
That much. Okay. Sarveshwar Shyam Sundar, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Prabhu.
Prabhu, yes, Prabhu. Yesterday we discussed the what does some Upanishads say about Tattvam and some Upanishads say Samadra Upanishad.
That is okay. Yeah, that's done. Next.
That's what Prabhu I have written in the notes.
Oh, very good. Akinjan Krishna, Prabhu.
Then we discussed about that changes of the body, vyabhicharidam, in relation to the soul. That so the body has six changes: birth, growth, sustenance, production of byproducts, deterioration, and death. Then we discussed that the soul does not have all these changes; it is nityatvam. Like that, we discussed.
Why we started discussing this?
All this discussion started, Prabhu, because that vastu, when we are started discussing about vastu from the first canto, second chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, that sloka we took, and we started discussing about the nature of the vastu.
Prabhu, I will tell, Prabhu. Prabhu, you in sixth anucheda the topic came about that we have to know the tat padartham, and yes. So we are seeing the tvam padartham, so the prayojanam to know the tvam padartham is not to know the tvam padartham or jiva, but to know the tat padartham. So that is different prayojanam.
Yes.
So then we started to
what is the rule? How can you say this?
Anyartha.
So we are studying about it.
That sutra is there, Prabhu. Anyarthascha paramarsha.
Anyarthascha paramarsha. Very good.
The deliberation on jiva is for anyartha, different prayojanam.
Yes.
Tvam padartham.
Yes. Good, good.
So then from the verse Bhagavatam 11, canto 3rd, chapter 38th verse, it tells about the tvam padartham. And we started the explanation about that the Atma is never born and it will never die and it does not grow. So past, present and future, all three phases of time, everything is covered. He was never born and he will never die and he does not grow or decay.
Yeah.
So this is about time. Then so then the soul can be understood to be pure consciousness, existing everywhere at all times and never being destroyed. Then we started through that the Atma is the witnesser of time. So, but the body is undergoing the changes. So Atma is the observer of changeable things. So Atma being observer, observer cannot undergo the changes of body, because then he cannot be called observer. So
yes, good.
So that's why Atma is called observer and the body is
Atma is observer. That's why we are seeing in the sloka Atma as observer or otherwise witnesser. So that is proving that there are no changes in the
Atma.
Yeah. Good. Okay. Thank you very much. Very nice. So nicely you told, Prabhu. Good. So, please try to focus, all the students. So, today, we are going to continue further. So, now, what is main goal? Our main goal is, we want to know about the Tatpadartha only. So Tatpadartha is that means what is the sambandhi about for this book, Srimad Bhagavatam, that is Tatpadartha. That is generally described as the Vastu by the Srila Vasudeva in the second sloka of Srimad Bhagavatam. He said simply it as a Vastu, Vastavam Vastu. That is meaning Vastavam means Paramartha Bhutam Vastu. That means it reaches the supreme goal. Then after that, Sukadeva Goswami also said that Vastu is nothing but the Tattvam. And that Tattvam is Advayam. So that means there is no other similar object like this, which is self-accomplished. So there is no similar or dissimilar object, which is self-accomplished. So like that kind of object is not there. So that's why we are saying this Tattvam is what? He is the Advayam. So then after that, so we are also proving that this tattvam is what? Advayam jnanam. So tattvam is what? Is jnanam also. Is purely jnanam. So after that, jnanam, this advay tattvam is a jnanam and also is being a tattvam. It is sukarupam and also it is nityam. These many things we derived there in that Anuscheda 4. Then after that, we came to know 4 or 5. So then after that, Nilapitadi Jnanam, Apurva Pakshi was asking, hey, according to us, so Tattvam, that's Jnanam actually. Jnanam, they are taking the point of Jnanam actually. When we said Tattvam as Jnanam, immediately they got idea. Hari, Jnanam is temporary only. And then how these people are saying this is a permanent and that is a Tattvam. So, because in their experience, Purva Pakshi's experience, Jnana means this is yellow, this is red, this is green, this is blue, like this. This is the shape of the Jnanam, they believe. And that Jnanam is only for moments it stays and it is finished. It is very temporary. So, in that case, so keeping that in their mind, so they are asking how it is possible. You are saying Jnanam and how it can be the stable and Nityam and also is permanent. and also Advayam. How it is possible? So this is a question raised. So then after that, to stay this, to explain this, to answer them, we started saying the first of all, our Tattvam is Advayam that we directly find from, found from the Srimad Bhagavatam 12.13.12. So, and also we discussed the several things there. What we discussed especially, one important point in that discussion about the Vastu, what is explained in that Srimad Bhagavatam, what is that important point? That point is, this Vastu is Brahmaatmaikatva Lakshanam. That means, the Vastu, whatever is defined, or Tattvam, whatever is explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam, is that object which can be studied initially by the similar knowledge between the Atma and that Tattvam or the Brahman. So that similar knowledge is the instrument, or otherwise is the initial instrument to study about the, or initial knowledge to study about the Vastu. So now after this we started trying to understand, yes. So that means anytime in the Vedanta studies, if we do the study of Jivatma, so that study is not really meant for the studying the Jivatma. That is not the purpose. But that study of Jivatma will help us to study the Paramatma, actually, the Paramtattva. So because both are similar, so if you study the similar, which is near to you, which is just is in your presence, in your premises. So then that kind of object, if you know, and then that similar kind of object only is the Brahman, then usually you can also understand Brahman. So that's why that Sadrishya Gnanam is useful for you. And not Sadrishya Gnanam, we cannot say Sadrishya Gnanam, but there's some similarity, not completely, some similarity of that. So is useful. So because in your presence only this Atma is there, that means you are only Atma, and that is in our availability, that is Paramatma. And that if you want to make study, if you want to do study of Paramatma, it's difficult. But now, so that's why we started now studying about the Atma, and what we came to know about this Atma. This Atma is explained. Is explained by the Pippalayan in his teachings to the Nimi. These Navayogis, out of that, one is the Pippalayan, and he was saying about the Atma. What he is saying about the Atma? He is saying, Atma is na jajana, that means he didn't have, it doesn't have, otherwise it was not having birth, no birth. So, and next, Marishyati, na Marishyati, it will not die. So it doesn't grow. So like this, in this past, present and future, so we are seeing this, the stability of this Atma. Like this we are seeing. And now, but we have to use the logic. We have to use some logic to say Atma is different from the body. Somehow now you have to understand your study should lead to figure out the completely properly the what is Atma. So that is our goal. So now this whole body, Atma is also there, and we don't know Atma is there or not, or Atma is there somehow. Bhagavatam is saying, so we are now studying. And this body is there, senses are there, mind is there, intelligence is there. And inside we are also saying Atma. And that Atma is Jnanam, we are saying. So then how to understand this? How to understand? That's the point here. Here, Srimad Bhagavatam is saying that this Atma is a Savanavit. Savanavit means is the observer of the time. Observer of the time means what? Is the observer of the time. Means he is the observer of the those particular changes which are happening in the due course of the time. To whom? To whom? To the Vyabhichari. To the Vyabhichari. Who is Vyabhichari? This. His body is a Vyabhichari. It is not. It's a Vyabhichari with respect to time. Because whatever in this minute, whatever body is there, that is not there in the next minute. Because if you see in the modern science also, our Dr. Saab knows. So in the modern science, every time this cell is dividing, every moment cell is dividing into two, and it's two, that each is dividing once again two like this. His whole body is, every minute it is reforming. And it's leading, it's a change is the obvious actually. So that's why this body is changing. That's why you cannot say that whatever is the body is there in the last moment is not there in the next moment. So that's why it is vyabhichari. Body is a vyabhichari. It is having this continual change. Continual change. And that kind of body is observed by whom? That kind of body is observed by the Atma. That is a Savanavit. This Atma. That is observing these changes. So that means in general, if you categorize the changes of the body, what are those changes? That is childhood, youth, old age, like that. So these stages of the body are witnessed by the Atma. So that is the point. Now, Atma is witnessing means whoever is witnessing, he should not undergo any changes. If he undergoes various changes, then he is not there. Na? When he is changing means he is not there. If he is changing every moment means whoever is there in the last moment, that person is not there in the next moment. Then that kind of person cannot be observed, you know. That kind of person cannot be observed. That kind of object cannot be observed. So to be an observer, you should be fixed. And then whatever the changes are coming, that you can see. Yes. Like example, in the cricket match. So players, they are always involved in the activities of the playing. And they cannot observe the whole game. So total game they cannot observe. It's not possible. So that's why whoever is not involved in these changes, that person is appointed as an umpire. And that umpire will be seeing the total game. The same way here, who is umpire? So changes are there in the body. Body can observe? No, body cannot observe because body itself is changing. So the observer is, or the witnesser is the Atma. Akshay Hari Prabhu, you raised your hand. Yes. Abdul Gopal Prabhu, aap kariye anu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Poo. Thank you, Poo. For allowing me to ask question, Poo.
Okay,
I have
please.
Question that I think we are using the Upmiti Pramana to understand the Tattva.
Upmiti Sadrishi Gnana, you see, I just immediately took back my sentence. So it's not exactly like Sadrishi Gnana. We are studying about the cow and then about the Nilgai, but just some similarity we are seeing and we are not completely able to identify even the Paramatma. But in the case of the Sadrishi Gnanam, you can figure out that object completely. But in this case, we cannot figure out. We can just know something, the initial amount of knowledge, initial basics of the absolute truth you can come to know by the studying this Jivatma. So that Jivatma is having some similarity with the Paramatma. So by that, some basic study you can do that, sir. But you cannot understand the completely the Tatpadartha.
Okay.
The Upamiti, that complete object is known actually. That is the difference. Here. Okay. Otherwise, why we have to do Bhakti? Then everyone will say that Upamiti is enough. And Bhakti will not do. And there is no need of the mercy also. Then then there is a big problem to the whole philosophy. Then they don't do any Abhideya. There is no need of do bhakti, and there is no need of the even the mercy of the Lord, and there is a whole philosophy will sit down actually. So that's why to that means Lord is known by the mercy of the Lord only. That is coming from the bhakti, and bhakti is what is the only the process which will help you to draw the mercy from the Lord. And that's why. But now, but this studying of the jivatma, you will be getting the basic idea of the Brahman, and that is helping you to get the Shraddha actually. So after getting the Shraddha, you have to do once again bhakti only. Why? So Shravanam Kirtanam you should do. And that will lead to the mercy to the Lord, mercy from the Lord. That will lead to draw mercy from the Lord. And when Lord gives mercy, then only you will come to know. You can realize. You can completely understand the object tat. Understood?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So next, here, Vebicharina, we are going little slow, and but still, I am observing students are not that much clear, closely not able to, are not following actually. So please try to. That's why I am asking questions. So please. Please try to understand, and this will be helpful for you while explaining. Or if you want to explain about the, you want to preach, especially in the preaching. So how to bring the faith on the Supreme Lord? So that can be brought actually by the this kind of explanations. Intellectual people, they can, those can be attracted. So next, Savanavit Tattat Kala Drashta Nahi Avastha. वताम दृष्टा तदवस्तो भवति अवस्था वताम दृष्टा तदवस्तो भवति सो अवस्था वताम दृष्टा मींस सो द ऑब्जर्वर ऑफ आर द विटनेसर ऑफ अवस्था वताम दैट मींस हु इज हैविंग द चेंजेस सो ऑब्जर्वर ऑफ दैट विल नॉट बी हैविंग द आर शुड नॉट बी हैविंग द चेंजेस Tad avastha means who is not having changes. Bhavati. So that's why niravastaha. From this word we understood jivatma is not having any changes. Niravastaha. There are no stages in the jivatma. This is childhood jivatma. This is youthful jivatma. And it is old age jivatma. Like that jivatma is also becoming, it is a small jivatma. And slowly it is becoming big jivatma. And after that it is becoming old jivatma like that. No. Okay, so thanks. Gokulanand Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu Hare Krishna.
Yes, Prabhu, please. I
was wondering if we can clarify, if we are explaining this to, let's say, to scientists, what do we mean by not change in the observer? Because one may raise the question that by observing you have thought processes.
Yes.
And can also transform yourself by perceiving the experiences of the body. So what is not changing? We know that the physical body is different, but what in the chit, in the consciousness, doesn't change? Because something has to go on with you, the observer.
That is coming in the next points. Yeah. So that means this knowledge, what this... this is blue, this is green, this kind of knowledge. So we are going to discuss. That is coming anyway. Wait, Prabhu. It will come. So, okay. And Jai Gopinath, do you have any another thing? What do you want to ask?
Yes, Prabhu. My question is that you answered Akshay Hari Prabhu's question by stating that by having this knowledge, we get Shraddha. And then again, we have to do our bhakti. But at this stage, we have got our shraddha much earlier, and then we are in this stage of our bhakti. So how much this knowledge for us related to?
So in our case also, this... Shraddha is not a concrete, is not a fixed one actually. Shraddha is also having various grades. So Komala Shraddha, Drudha Shraddha, and also intermediate Shraddha. Mm-hmm. Even in that also, there are levels are there. It's like it's an analog curve. It's not a discrete, it's not a digital curve, either one or zero. So it's like a continual process. That means our Shraddha keep on increasing. As much as our Shraddha increases, so that will that will lead to us to strictly follow the process. And that's why, so we cannot say that our Shraddha is now completely very strong Shraddha is there. So we are trying to improve our Shraddha. So in this stage, so some devotees maybe initial stages, so whoever is not having the proper understanding of Paramatma and the Jivatma, so it will be useful. Otherwise, what is happening to me if I get the knowledge, so where it goes, and what is this material knowledge? So this kind of unclearance, if it is there, then so many times we may think that one part of the book is unclear, that will affect another part also. Sometimes you may think, oh, I don't know, many things are not clear and whatever, how much this is also is perfect, and that kind of problems will come actually. So that's why Prabhupada says to his disciples and to others, everyone, so you have to read my books, every line very scrutinizedly, and try to understand this. And it's a worst and foremost thing actually. And he was stressing this actually, because this knowledge, Shastra Artha Vishwasa, that means this knowledge of the scriptures is very much important. Many times, many things we may not know. So that's why we might be doing some mistakes. And then we come to know about that. And then once again, we are improving our sadhana quality. Quality of the sadhana also will increase. So because of increased Shraddha will lead to the quality of this sadhana also, definitely. So like this, it is useful, Prabhu.
So we can put it in a nutshell that at any stage, this knowledge will help us to improve our Shraddha.
Shraddha, and not only Shraddha, so this is a part of the Srimad Bhagavatam. It is also gives the Rati and Bhakti. So Rati and Bhakti also it gives. Because in this, ultimately, we are, once again, for initial people, it is giving the Shraddha. Then after that, we are glorifying the Krishna, actually. How? That means this sloka, after you come to know, so Jivatma is only this much, is limited. And this, but Supreme Lord is unlimited, and he is Ananta. So then in that level, so you can, same sloka, you can use to glorify the Krishna also. And same knowledge. Yeah, the limitedness of the Jivatma is understood here. And after that is also establishing the unlimitedness of the Bhagavan. So that will bring once again the more respect, as much as we come to know our insignificance. So that will lead to the even further stages of the bhakti. It will be helpful for the further stages of the bhakti also, not only just Shraddha. Yeah.
Thank you very much. Sir. Thank you.
Okay, Hare Krishna. So next, since Jivatma is not having any stages or any changes, so it is said as Niravastaha. Then who is this? That means Jivatma is Niravastaha. That is understood till now. Ataha aha upalabdhi matram. That's why Jivatma is said as Jnanaika Rupam. In the sloka, what is said? Upalabdhi matram. That means this, the object which is not having any changes, what is that? What is that object? That is Atma. What is that? That is knowledge. Jnanaika Rupam. So then, katam bhutam, what kind of knowledge that is? Sarvatra dehe shashvat sarvada anuvartamanam. This Upalabdhi matra means it's knowledge, otherwise generally Prabhupada translated as knowledge, but also we can see our Sanskrit scholars like Gopi Pradhan Prabhu and others. So they are translating as a consciousness. So consciousness also we can use. This Jivatma is what? Is a consciousness. Jnanam means you can say consciousness or otherwise knowledge. It is consciousness. Jivatma is purely conscious. Katam bhutam. So how it is, what kind of consciousness, you may ask. This Jivatma is spreading its consciousness into the entire body. Sarvada, sarvatra means in the entire deha, sarvada anuvartamanam. It is existing. That means this consciousness is like you say, like the lamp is there. Lamp is at one place, but its prakasha is spreading entire room. Same way, Jivatma is consciousness, and that is spreading entire body. Jivatma is at one place only, but its consciousness is like the lights, that's a lamp's light. Prakasha is spreading entire room, same way here also. So spreading entire body, sarvatra, sarvada, anuvartamanam, always exist. Now the point is coming. Nanu neelagnanam nashtam pitagnanam jatam iti pratitehe. Iti pratiti neelagnanam nashtam pitagnanam jatam iti pratitehe na gnanasya anapayitvam. The same point. Actually, in the previous anuschedas, the Purupakshi, whatever the point he raised, same point also he raised. What neelagnanam nashtam pitagnanam jatam. In general, actually, what happens? If we see the object which is in the blue color, so then you will immediately come to know this object is in blue. This is blue object. Then after that, immediately now that object is removed and in front of your eyes one yellow object is kept. Then what will happen? This object is in yellow color. This is second knowledge is generated. When second knowledge is generated, first knowledge is finished. That is destroyed. That is destroyed and destroyed, and it may lead to the memory, that means smriti. But that is destroyed, and that knowledge formed the smriti and it finished. So like this, every minute, every moment, that means you are seeing so many objects and the knowledge is created and it is being destroyed. Or otherwise consciousness here, neela gnanam, there also upalabdhi matram is gnanam you took. So that's why here you are also the knowledge or the consciousness. This consciousness of the blue or the consciousness of yellow. This is nasta. This is destroyed. Then how can you say this consciousness which is coming from the Jivatma is eternal? Is shashwat, shashwat. That means always. That's always existing. How can you say this? Understand? The point is here, knowledge means consciousness. I am using the word knowledge or the consciousness as the alternative words. But you take that as a consciousness. This consciousness of blue or consciousness of red or the yellow is being observed as temporary. So based upon this principle, Purupakshi is putting a question to us. How can you say? So Jivatma is being consciousness. How it can be permanent? It is also destroyed. One may say. Understood, everyone? Any question here? No. Okay. Next. Then answer is said, Tatra Aha. Answer to this is, Indriya Baleneti Sadaiva Jnanam Ekam Indriya Balena Vividam Kalpitam. That means one consciousness due to Sat means Sat Eva. Sat Eva means Jnanam Ekam. Here in this sloka, Sat is there. That Sat is glossed as what? Sat means Jnanam, means consciousness. Ekam, that means is one. Indriya Balena, due to the power of the senses. Vividam Kalpitam, it looks many, but it is not many. It looks like many. That means one consciousness is looking like many. Because of what? Because of the power of the senses. That means Neelajyakara Vrittayaha Eva Jayante Cha Na Jnanam Iti Bhavaha. What it means? Iti Bhavaha means, it means this Neelajyakara Vrittayaha Eva Jayante, and the Neelajyakara Vritti is produced and it is finished. Na Jnanam, not the consciousness. Not the consciousness is produced and consciousness is destroyed. Just I am explaining on the board. I will try. Of course, I want. I am not. Because this is the area actually we polemics actually here in this area. Much clarity we need actually in our Gaudiya Vaishnavism. I am also keep on studying on these things. And that's why I am also a student. I am trying to learn. I am presenting my idea. If you people have even better than this, maybe. So then we can have that. This is Jivatma. And suppose you take this as the body. And this is consciousness. Is all pervading. That means it's pervading in the entire body. That means it is sitting in the place of heart, sitting in the heart, and it is spreading its consciousness into entire body. So that living symptoms you are seeing and even in the dead matter, like our hand is having some living symptoms because of the presence of this consciousness which is coming from the soul. And now we sometimes see the object. This is the blue pen. And when you see this, we are getting the consciousness of blue or the knowledge of blue. This is blue pen. This kind of awareness you are getting or not, this kind of knowledge or the awareness something or consciousness, that kind of, like you see, when you keep one just any object, dead matter, like take one mobile. this mobile is kept in front of a blue pen. So in the mobile, is there any, that means, changes? Are this, is this mobile is getting any awareness of that pen? That means this pen is blue. Is no. No. It is not getting that kind of knowledge. But you are getting, when you see, you are getting this knowledge. This is blue pen. And this knowledge is produced when you see that object with your senses, that is eyes. If when you see with the eyes, then immediately you are getting this. So this is produced, and when you show to your eyes, removing this object and another object, which is blue, a blue pen, now it's a red pen, yellow pen, yellow pen. Then this is blue pen. This knowledge is finished, destroyed. And what you are getting? This is yellow. This is yellow pen. This knowledge you are getting now. This kind of awareness or this kind of consciousness you are having now. What about this? This knowledge is coming and going, and you are saying Jivatma is conscious. Jivatma is Jnanam. Jivatma is Upalabdhi. All the same meanings. Upalabdhi matram. So it is also, how can you say it is permanent? Now, then what is the answer? This is blue pen and this is yellow pen. These are the due to the only the senses. These are due to only the senses. And these senses are capturing the object, and after that, what is said? That is, those senses are giving that information to the heart or antakarana or otherwise mind, whatever you can take. Heart, mind, antakarana are the same. Antakarana, otherwise. Antakarana. That is equal to mind. And in that mind, so like you see, already previously I said, this is the heart if you take, and this is the eye, and this is the pen. This antakaranam is traveling through the eyes and is reaching to the object, and that object is, that means antakaranam is traveling, means not entire antakaranam is traveling. So one vritti of this antakarana, one vritti means is a function of the antakaranam. So that is traveling from the eyes to this object and getting the shape of the object. And so that vritti is now is traveling and getting the shape of this. So then that shape is printed here. And this is what? This vritti is nothing but, this is blue pen. This is blue pen. And this vritti is staying and it is finished. But behind this antakaranam, so who is there mainly? This soul, that is Atma. Atma is there, and Atma is Atma's consciousness is pervading everywhere into this mind, antakaranam, and also into the eyes. And that consciousness is not changing. Only by the force of the, by the power of the senses, and the senses means this eyes and also antakaranam. So this vritti is generated. And but this jivatma and its consciousness, that is not transformed actually. That's the point. Sadeva, how can you say vikalpitam? Indriya balena vikalpitam. So sat eva indriya balena vikalpitam. This is sat actually. Soul is sat. Soul means consciousness. That is sat. And that now, so, but you see, now to have this vritti, this mind and these senses all should be active. And that activeness is due to the consciousness of the soul only. But the point is what? But the point, there is no change in this soul. There is no change. Only in the mind, in the heart, or in the antakarana, vritti is formed. And that is formed and that is destroyed. That is the point he is saying here. Vipalayan is saying. Example is giving, he is giving just for our sake. That is the prana example. Like the life aid. Like the life. Okay. Manas.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Just briefly, I'm wondering this kalpitam, this function of imagining, is this a function of antakarana?
It is a function of antakarana. Vividam kalpitam. Yes. Yeah. Indriya balena vividam kalpitam. And so, like the life eye is one only, but when it goes to the different parts, it is looking, it is getting the different names. Vyana, Udana, Apana, like when that same life eye, when it flows, it is named as differently. But of course, it is one only. But in the different parts, it is named as differently. And this consciousness, which is coming from the soul, is stable. But for the time being, by the power of the senses, okay, this a vritti is created with the help of this consciousness. And it looks that this consciousness of soul is changing. No, not the consciousness of the soul is changing. Just some vritti is created. And with the help of this consciousness only. And this is our point actually here, he said. It looks like it's becoming many, but it is not. It is one only. This jivatma's jnanam is same, is constant. And only the urtis are formed. Jivatma is by nature, it is pure. If you see in the next coming, Jadabharat says, all of you might be knowing what he says. I About the Atma and Paramatma, he also says, Kshetrajnayeta manaso vibhutir jivasya maya rachitasya nitya avirhita kvapi tirohitascha shuddho vichishte yavishuddha kartuhu. If you observe the meaning of this sloka, shuddha means jivatma. Jivatma is the soul, is pure actually. It is not having any impurities. There is no need to transform the soul actually. Need to transform only the heart. Heart should be transformed. Soul is already pure, but suddha, this Atma is pure. What? Vichashte. This is entering. That means the consciousness of the soul is entering into the various vrittis. This is a vritti. This is blue, this is green, this is this. And entering into these vrittis and thinking himself as what? He's thinking himself as maya rastasi. Avirhitaha kvachit. Avirhitaha kvapi tirohitascha. That means thinking himself as is this, that, and that. That means sometimes, for example, what I can say, I can say, now you are seeing instead of this pen, if you keep a mirror here, and this eye is seeing the mirror, that means you're seeing the face, your face, then the vritti is formed here, the face, the form of face is formed here. Now the soul, what it will think? It is pure by nature, but since it is associated with the impure heart, and also this soul is tied with this heart, with the false ego. Because of this false ego, this soul is tightly bounded with this impure heart. And in this heart, the vritti, that means the face, is formed. And then Atma, what it thinks? Thinks that it unnecessarily, falsely claims, soul, I am big, I am beautiful, I am this, I am that. So actually, this Atma is pure and is always pure, but it is what? Falsely claiming because of the association with the impure heart. That means actually impurity is there in where? Impurity is there in the heart, not the soul. Soul is by nature is pure. And there is no transformation in the soul. That's why we say heart transformation. Heart has to be transformed. This is pure. All these vrittis only. In the whole day, if you see many, many things, various vrittis are formed in the heart. And those are all so falsely claimed by the soul because of the false ego and feeling the attachment with this material world. Now, if you purify this heart, then you will see the things as it is. You will see that you are not these vrittis. These vrittis are cleaned. Heart is clean now, and it is clean now. You'll understand that I am pure then. Then also, if it is cleaned with the Nishkama Karma Yoga, then what? In the Nishkama Karma Yoga, you are stopping to form these vrittis. The Nishkama Karma Yoga, what is the process? These vrittis are not allowed to form because samasitoshna sukadukkeshu samasangavavarjita. So that means dukkeshanat digvamana sukesh vigatasvara vitaraga bhayakroda. You are trying to maintain equilibrium in your heart. That means you are not allowing your heart to form the various vrittis. You are stopping. So that's why. In that way, heart is purified. That is Nishkama Karma. But in the process of bhakti, Hridyantastho Hyabhadrani, Hridyantastaha, that means, Hridi means he is in the heart. Hridi means heart. Hridyantastha abhadrani, whatever are there, various samskaras, various things, which make this jivatma to be tightly connected with this, with the various vrittis of the heart. And all these samskaras, these sinful tendencies, all will be clean by the name. Then what? Then you will understand yourself. And also you will understand. So because in that purified heart, when you do bhakti, Krishna will come and sit in this heart. Directly you can see. Of course, this jivatma is not outside to the heart, it is inside only, but just for the pictorial, just for the explanation, I took out the jivatma outside to the heart, but this totally is heart, and inside only jivatma is sitting. And also, understand? Some extent I am trying, actually I am not so perfect, because I am also studying the Advaita, that's Ramanuja's definitions, Dharmi Bhuta Jnanam, Saru Bhuta Jnanam. A lot of things are there. It's not that the way I am explaining, it's very vague explanation. Inside, so many things are there. What are the samskaras? What are the different bhavas? That means, and how they, which comes into which category? Many subtleties are there. It's just our, my explanation is a basic explanation of what is there in that book. Atusandra, I am saying that. And this is also area we have to, because Jiva Goswami is using all these basic terms, Swarupa Gnanam, or this. This is day-to-day knowledge, whatever. That Dharmi Bhuta Gnanam, these are all he is using directly, and I don't know which book he defined those, the basics. But I think maybe he is in the Tattva Sandarbha also, he is saying he is following the Ramanuja. Ramanuja's philosophy also. Might be we can take that. And main thing is, actually, generally what happens, anyone wants to give the commentary on the Brahma Sutras. So any sampradaya means sampradaya, they will be first defining the their explanation of the Brahma Sutras. Before that, they define the pramanas. What are the various pramanas, and in detail, everything they define. And that is the thing actually is necessary for every sampradaya. And deeply about the pramanas, I didn't find actually, because of course I have no much knowledge also. And maybe other, Baldev Dabhushan also in the Siddhanta Prana, much is not there actually. And I don't know. And even I don't know the detailedly that book completely. So, but Sandarbhas, I know clearly. Whatever that Sandarbha we have seen, that much only he said about the Pramanas. But inside that, what is Swarupa Gnanam? Definition of the Swarupa Gnanam, definition of the Dharmi Bhuta Gnanam. That the internal mechanism, that means each, that's Bhakti Vrittis, how they are formed, and this material Bhautik Jagat Vrittis, how they are formed. And what is the difference between that? And where bhakti stays, that means if you do the actual devotional activities, where it they're staying, and this how the cleaning process is happening, the detailed inside discussion. That I don't know. And this is the process. We'll be learning and we'll study and learn. Yeah, if someone knows, maybe. But you understood now, the basic now, the thing is, in the day-to-day knowledge, so whatever the objects, by seeing the objects, whatever knowledge is generated, that is generated by the senses. That means internal and external senses. That means antakarana and the external senses. That's the five senses. All together, they are making that. But there is nothing to do with the Atma. Atma is not at all, is not having any changes in its Swarupa. There is no changes in the Swarupa of the Atma. That is a fundamental point he is touching. Vipalayan is saying that is the main point. That is due to Indriya Balena. The important word in this sloka is what? Indriya Balena. It is by the power of the senses only, not by the Atma. Yes, Vikas Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Pranam.
So, Prabhu, what I understood is that Atma is a reservoir of all knowledge, all existing, non-existing knowledge. And with the senses, the vritti or the function which is getting formed is the interaction of these material things, which is senses and all other aspects of it. So in order to prove that the transformation is happening of the heart means the transformation of the chit, which is the thought process, and then the object of senses and other things. So which almost means that the self-realization is already existing within all of us. And we are trying to clean our internal core in the process to get there.
Yes.
So, and the Prabhu, other thing you were talking about, that the details which talks about the whole interactions of each of sense objects, senses, and their movement within the subtle thinking process and vrittis and other things is written somewhere in any book.
That is for our, actually we can refer Prabhu Yatindra Matadipika. That is the one book.
Which one, Prabhu, if you can tell slowly to me.
Yatindra Matadipika, I can show the book then. Are you able to see?
Yes.
This is our mirror image. It is.
Yes.
It is giving mirror.
Yes.
Yatindra Matadipika.
Yes.
Is it?
And written by, this is?
This is actually the main Vakyakar is this, but the main is Srinivasa Acharya Pranita. This is Sri Vaishnava actually he is. Srinivasa Acharya. So I think he is very long back. He is not the recent person. So very old person. So he wrote. That means he actually, Prabhu, what happens? Acharyas, nobody gives the so many details of these processes. The Prem Acharyas, they don't give. But after that, later, the many followers, they come. So they study the books and the explanations of the Acharyas. And then after that, understanding the whole picture, they will develop this kind of the processes, how the mechanisms. So that's why, that is the thing actually, even Gaudi Parampara. So since we are being more inclined to the Sankirtan movement, so we can see that some kind of lacking in this area actually. So defining and I'm saying my opinion only it is. So that's like the educational culture. But actually Sankirtan means Prabhupada also defines. So books and reading the books is also comes under the Sankirtan. It's not that the Kirtan means, Sankirtan means just playing Mridanga and Kartal and singing. That's not the Sankirtan. Sankirtan means books. And also this, he Prabhupada says in the four movements. So that Sankirtan, actually, in one can say Sankirtan movement we are, and we are weak in the Sankirtan. We are weak in the Sankirtan. Reading the books and also deeply analyzing and understanding, and so further writing the things and that. So
it's I do ponder on these subjects. Like, for example, Prabhu, like samskaras, right? So any experience we sense using the sense organs and sense objects, those experience get stored in our memory. And they are the impression of samskaras from time immemorial.
Yes.
So that way, Prabhu, like everything little is quite detailed defined, but I have not read like completely like how the internal transformation is happening, where bhakti stays, and you know, all those stages. These things are quite available.
Some basics are available, but the main point is, so it is a still area. Our movement is 500 years old movement, Gaudi Vaishnava Sampradaya. So, but compared to if you see the others, like Advaitins, they are 1200 years old, and the Ramanuja is 900 years old, Madhva 800 years old. So they are very actually elder than us. So of course we can see many things there, but of course we can, it's our, still we have so much time, and we cannot compare with them. So with their systems, and they have the many, that means this kind of books, of course it will come, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Kali Gavatara, and he's a prominent, is the Supreme Lord himself, and he wanted actually so this movement to go further. So definitely many acharyas will come in this area, in this sampradaya, and further things will happen. But the basic things already, Jiva Goswami and also other our Vaishnava acharyas, Baldev Vidya Bhushan, and they have given some major ideas, not some major things already done, but just by seeing the closely observing like this kind of things and properly. So we should define the definitions, paribhasha shabdas, basic definitions systematically. If you make that book, that will be a very wonderful thing.
Thank you, Prabhu.
So Maharaj, you want to comment something? If I spoke anything wrong, please correct me. And okay, unmute 1 second.
No, nothing to comment. Just, I agree. Our tradition is young, and over time it develops. And this is one way that it develops, is it's a commentarial tradition, which means we have commentary to the Bhagavatam by our six Goswamis, especially Srila Jiva Goswami. And then Bhakti Bhushan, and then there will be more commentaries. Even we see our Gopi Paranadana Prabhu has written his own commentaries, which are very nice. There's so much illumination there.
Yeah.
So it's an ongoing process.
Yes, yes. Yes, ma'am. So it's an ongoing process, yes. Like that, sometimes we will be seeing the commentaries on the commentaries. So one may can try to take the Krama Sandarbha and comment each line, and what is the intention of the, that means the main speaker, main author. And that can be done. And also Sandarbha's Mula is there. And the Mula commentary can be done. And also on the Sarvasamvadini is, and once again, main thing is understanding Sarvasamvadini itself is one of the challenging thing. And also giving the commentary, very authentic commentary on that. And that is also, is like this, several works are pending in our line. And yeah, that is. Okay, just two lines are there in this that I want to continue and finish. Next. So from this, we are understanding that there is no change in the soul. And it is jnana swarup, jnanam is purely consciousness, and it is not changing. only the, because by the force, by the power of the senses only, that temporary knowledge is created and that is finished, created and finished. And this is establishing that the difference between the Jivatma and the body, that subtle and gross body. These two things. One is what? Here, Tarka, it is said that Agama Pai Tad Avadi Bedena Pratama Tarkaha. What is the difference between the body and the Jivatma? Body is having the changes and Jivatma is not having the changes. This difference is establishing clearly. Jivatma is separate from the body. So that's why many people, they are trying to understand, even modern scientists, they are trying to understand, that means what is this total mechanism, whatever is happening in the body, they are also trying to understand. But it is simply, very nicely, it is explained in our this Srimad Bhagavatam sloka. So, but the main point is they don't have faith on the Srimad Bhagavatam. But in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, but it is easy to establish Srimad Bhagavatam. So that's why, so if we establish Srimad Bhagavatam, and then after that, we can easily speak the many facts and make them to understand many things easily. Otherwise, directly if we speak from the Srimad Bhagavatam, sometimes they may not accept this. That is a challenge. And now, so that's why Srimad Bhagavatam is saying that Jivatma is observer only, is a witnesser. So from this we understood changes are there in the body, but no changes are there in the soul. So this is establishing, this is the first tarka, this is the first logic to say Jivatma is separate from the body. Next, drashtru drushya bhedena dityopi tarkaha. So also we are seeing here Jivatma savanavit, that means is a drashta, is a seer. So the observer is always different from the observed. So drashtru drushya. So whatever he is observing, that is separate from the observer. Drashtru drushya bhedena. So what he said here, Jivatma is said as observer and body is said as is observed, being observed. So that's why this difference is also establishing the Jivatma. He is separate from the body. So drashtru drushya bhedena dityopi tarkaha jneyaha. Finally, next, vyabhicharishu avasthitasya avyabhichare drishtantaha prana yatha iti. So final line, this is saying that vyabhicharishu avasthitasya avyabhichare drishtantaha. So Jivatma is among the, or is among the changing things, unchanging one. So for this example is, we want an example for unchanging thing among the changing things. So that is, example is prana. Prana example is given. Prana is one, and but it is flowing into different body parts and getting the name is different. But actually prana is one. And this is over that anusheda. Next anusheda is just, I am going to give the another 4 minutes are there. So they are just a basic idea, I will say. So now here in the next one says what is said, drishtantam vivrunvan indriyadi layena nirvikaratmopalabdhi darshayati. Now we are going to say indriyadi layena, that means if all the senses and the mind, intelligence and ego, they dissolve, then who is remaining? Atma is remaining. And if you say, if you establish that Atma is not having the changes, so then, so Indriyadi, okay, sorry, Drishtanta Virunan, Indriyadi Layena Nirvikara Atmopalabdi Darshati. So then that Atma is observed without any changes. Then we can say changes are due to only the senses. Just I will say what I want to say. Once again, I will repeat. Please see the board. So here I am saying, hey. what we want to say, we want to say this is the Atma and this box is senses, mind, that means antakarana, you can say mind, and also false ego, all this, mind and false ego. Now what we are saying, this Atma is nirvikara, there are no changes in this. And it is a jnanam, and that jnanam is also not changing. It is alone, it's a pure always. But only the thing is this box. These are the senses and also internal and external senses, everything. These are only the causes for the having the temporary knowledge. And now the point is what? If we dissolve all this, that means if we disconnect all these with the soul, from the soul, if we disconnect all these from the soul, and then this Atma is experienced as the nirvikara, that means unchanged thing, or the object which is not having the changes, in that way, if you experience this, then we can say that any changes we are experiencing means those are all due to subtle body only, subtle and gross body only. That can be reconfirmed. So what? To establish the unchangingness of the Jivatma, what we are going to do? We want to say this, all this subtle body, that means in senses and the mind and false ego, everything is dissolved. Everything is dissolved. Then what will happen? Then you will be experiencing yourself as Atma as nirvikara, no vikaras, no changes. That we are going to do tomorrow. So how these things are all dissolved, or how these things are disconnected from this Atma, that we are going to see tomorrow's class. Thank you very much. Questions? Any question? Any comment? No questions. Such a heavy topic, but no questions. Why? Not understanding or understanding? I
don't. Questions?
Yes, Prabhu. Gokulan, Prabhu, please.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. I also ask.
Prabhu, you're muted.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu, can I ask?
Now I am mute.
Yes, Prabhu.
How do we explain, if we are, if the soul is a vasta, is observing, and so how is observing? What is the karanam, the instrument that it's using? That one may question, because we are saying that the senses pertain to the.
Okay, tomorrow's question. Now this will be in the tomorrow. Yeah, that we'll see. What is the karanam you are asking? I understood. So tomorrow we'll discuss that.
Okay.
Ashtayar Prabhu, carry on.
My question is, the soul has these three guns, Sat, Chit, Ananda.
Can you speak into mic and loudly?
Yes, of course. Generally, we hear that soul has three qualities, Sat, Chit, Ananda.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when we discuss that soul is observer, we draw the quality of eternality. Mm. That soul is Sat. Mm. And then we said, what kind of Sat? It is Jnanek Rupam. Mm. Then we tried to prove that how Jnan can be fixed. So we tried to, I think, merging these two features, Sat and Chit, the knowledge feature and the eternity feature of a soul. And something like that. If we keep them separate, then this concept will be very easy to understand.
So actually here, Prabhu, we are saying, so mainly what we want to say, we want to bring out the difference between the body and the soul.
Okay.
That is the main thing actually is happening, because we want to study the nature of the soul. Okay. And for that, first of all, what we have to do? We have to see the difference between the body and the soul.
Yes.
So body is having this kind of changes and soul is not having. And the different logics we are developing, and so that we can easily understand difference between body and the soul.
Yes.
And in that meanwhile, we are also seeing that in this process, previously we have doubt, this Nilagnanam and Pitagnanam is temporary, then how this Jivatma is also Gnanam. Like Paramatma, there we have seen Paramatma is Gnanam. But here, Jivatma is also Gnanam we are seeing. Then how this Gnanam is permanent. So then we understood that whatever Nila Gnanam, Pita Gnanam is coming, that is due to only the senses. That is nothing with the... So in the soul, actually. In the soul, there is no change.
Yeah.
Okay. So that point we understood. Just in the path of this understanding. Okay.
Yes.
Whole thing is just to establish a difference between the Jivatma and the body. That is the main important thing we are doing.
Yes.